Hello everyone, this is Meara, and this was the second part of my 1.9 pre-release. I will be going over things that I didn't cover in the last video, and I will also be covering pre-release version 4. Okay, so first I wanted to talk about, or finish up, Alchemy, and talk about the new stuff. First you have Sugar, which is speed increase, Spider Eye, which is poison, Gas Tear, which is now health regen, versus before it was health, instant health. The fermented spider eye adds a negative effect. The glistening, which I guess could work. Melon now is instant health. Magma cream is fire resistance. And then the blazing powder, which is strength. Then of course you have these items, with Netherwort, which makes a neutral base. It has no effect on its own, and probably should be used to make bases. Then you have Glowstone, which increases the effectiveness, but decreases the duration. Redstone increases the duration, but lowers the effect. And then Gunpowder, from Creepers, and Ghasts, which makes it a splash potion. Oh, and if you wanted to know how to make a brewing stand, you take 3 cobblestone like so, and a blaze rod, and fermented spider eye with sugar and a brown mushroom. Where was I? Oh, and a cauldron is like this. It's like iron ingots around, like, I guess, in a U-shape. Upside down pens. So here are the different potions that you can make. These are the new bases. These are the bases. Awkward, which is just Netherwort. Thick potion, which is just redstone. Potion of weakness, which is just fermented spider eye. However, you can take the awkward potion and add a spider's eye to it, or fermented spider eye to it, and still get awkward. I mean, weakness. So, but this is just a cheaper way to make this. And then thick or mundane, which is glowstone dust. However, you can also use any of these and still get the mundane. So to get potion of swiftness, you take your awkward potion and add sugar. Strength, you add blazing powder. Healing, the glistering. We're just going to call it the glowing melon, okay? The glowing melon, and then potion of regeneration, a ghast tear, and potion of fire resistance, magma cream. Then you take your potion of swiftness and add a fermented spider eye, and you get potion of slowness. You also have a potion of poison, which is just your awkward and spider eye. And then you also have a potion of harming, instant damage, which you add on top of that a fermented spider eye. Then you can make potion of harming by adding glowstone dust, and make it a splash potion by adding gunpowder, which we are going to now test. Let me find something to throw it on. I had an enderman bringing me a flower around here somewhere. Where is he? I throw it on my livestock, but they're the only two that I have. Let's try to find somebody. And of course, everybody's gone. That's how it normally works. They go generate maybe some more. Something new. Ah, here's some sheep. So, up. Right click. And of course you can do that with any potion. I'm assuming even the healing potions. So other than that, that is it for Alchemy. They added throwing. They added melons and splash to it. And of course I forgot to tell you how to make the glistering melon. take a golden nugget, which you get our gold nugget from Pigmen. Put it over a melon slice, and there you go. This is a magma slime. This is actually kind of cool. You see the little animation when they, like, separate? And okay, you can die now. Woo! Come on, little guy. You're stuck? Oh, how cute. I like slimes better than you. Doesn't look like they drop anything but experience. Anyway, so these guys drop the... what is it called again? The stuff. The blaze powder, I think, maybe? Not exactly sure if they were supposed to or not. Another thing I didn't catch up on in the last video was where the gold nuggets drop from. I figured it out already. They drop from these guys, which are probably really awesome, that are really awesome experience. Where I killed your friend, aren't you supposed to be coming for me? Anyway, they drop nuggets. I don't know if they did or not. Alright. The thing they added that I didn't cover previously was that the fact that you can now repair your items. You take two damaged items of the same, and I believe these can also be enchanted, and you can still get it, but you lose the enchant. Enchanting got changed. As we can see here, it's the same as before. Goes up to 27, 31. We're just gonna pick a 7 here. And you hit it, and now it tells you fire aspect. Ooh, so sharpness 1, knockback 1, and fire aspect 1. We're gonna have to go find somebody else to kill now. See what this does. I believe there's also smite, which is another one that I saw. I don't know what they do, but they also add a cool little particle effect, so let me go get some helpless victims to help us here. Okay, so poor little helpless cow will help us in this demonstration, and oh, damn. That is nice. Die, sheepy. Die. Oh, that's nice. So, it knocks it back, it hits it for more damage, and catches them on fire. Creepers, look out. Poor things. Another thing they added in version 4 is now the ender eyes, which I don't know how to make them, don't ask. Now find strongholds. So there's a stronghold, as you can see by the debug markers and my little hole. Right click them, they go up like that, and either they fall down like that, or they explode. Let's see if I can get it to explode. But anyway, they always go towards the nearest stronghold. So if I go over here, oh, there's a stronghold underneath. So if I go way over here, past the stronghold, it should. And it didn't. So I don't know if it's actually working. Or it's pointing me to another one. Because it really wants to go towards the sun. So let's try it over here. See if this works. Nope, still wants to go towards the sun. Let's see if I... let's see if I can get it to explode. The other effect. And there you go. So now let's go check out the end, or the Ender Realm. Let me head on down there. I probably will get lost. So be right back. Hopefully this time I have my sound checked, fixed. Sorry. One thing that I forgot to show was now the moon has phases. I guess if you don't know what that means, a new moon and a full moon are phases, and as you can see there, instead of being a big circle, it's only three quarters. And so, yeah, that's really cool. I don't know if the sun actually has phases, which would not make sense because I don't think the sun has phases. But yeah, so, I didn't mean to do that. So now we got cool, better moon, which is more of a realistic moon, I guess you could say. Get off my bar. Sorry, this is a little pet peeve. I'm not doing anything. I have to have nothing on my bar. Let's go way up. So yeah. Now, on to the end. So here is a working ender portal. Excuse me about this. Basically, all you have to do when you find this is take your ender eyes and line the portal. Whoops, I just fell in. Anyway, we get to see this. Underworld. Or the end, as it's called. Not much to it yet. It's kind of cool, I guess. There's not much to it. As you can see, I've been up here before. I was trying to get one of these blocks. But it just turns to cobblestone. Static. Oh. So it's floating islands. Like a floating realm. So I guess if you wanted your skylands, so I guess below here is the void. Here you go. And see, this is just, it turns into cobblestone, so I'm assuming it's not finished yet. Because when you pick at it normally, it just turns into cobblestone, so it's like... Ooh, that's a really messed up picture. Kind of giving me a little bit of a headache. So... yeah. And it doesn't seem to be endless either. So right now, it's not an ideal place to be. Because there's really nothing up here but Enderman. And obsidian. Lots of obsidian. But I mean, as you can see, I can dig through this stuff. This Enderstone. And there's nothing. And then right to the surface. Try not to look at these guys. And it's a giant floating island, so I guess it would be a cool place to have a base, I guess. And I think these pillars have something to do with the Ender Dragons. But of course, there's no Ender Dragons in pre-release 4. I don't think he would release that yet. I think he needs to work on it a little bit more, even though it is awesome looking so far. It's probably the best mob he's created, so far. So that will conclude this video with a weird, space. I guess this is death. It's like Doom ending. You go to hell. Cool formation. Kind of looks like Swiss. Kind of looks like cheese. Like really, really bad cheese. Milk that's been sitting in a cup for a week or two. So yeah, I'm assuming the dragons will perch on these towers. Even though some don't quite generate all the way. They'll, perch on these towers, and you have to, be all heroic and stuff. Which, frankly, they should be gold. But we won't go there. But I guess it's another place to farm a lot of obsidian and whatever this stuff is. Assuming he's going to add more to it. So, don't think this is the end. Yet. Happy gaming. I'm going to keep you alive and call you Buford. Yep. In here. How about a brown mushroom? Can I do that? What the? Huh? Okay, I gotta fix this. Okay, so note to self, oh my god. With brewing, a new item has come up, which is this glycerine, I'm not even gonna bother. I'm wanting to call it glycerine melon.